Hey folks, Andy here, and welcome to Designer's Universe. Our good old friend Illustrator has so many little functions that can improve our workflow, but they are either kinda hidden or we are simply not aware of, because there's just too many things to learn about the software. So today, I selected 5 among my favorite Illustrator functions to share with you. Let's go! Right off the bat, we creatives are not particularly known for being good in math. So it's a whole new world to find out that you can perform math operations inside of any numerical input field on Illustrator, like position, size, opacity, or stroke weight. That's right, you can add, subtract, multiply, and divide all inside of input fields. You can even use percentages on your operations if you wish so. Still regarding input fields, did you know that you can just hover the mouse cursor over an input field and use the mouse wheel to increase or decrease the value? This works for any numerical input field, both regular numerical inputs and percentage inputs. It will always round decimal values, either up or down, depending on if you're increasing or decreasing the value. And if you hold shift, it will go up or down in increments of 10. I find this feature incredibly helpful, especially with small numbers like stroke weight, opacity, or font size, and it can significantly speed your workflow. Bonus tip, if you hover the mouse cursor over a drop-down menu, you can also switch between the options using the mouse wheel. For the longest time, I struggled to align anchor points whenever I needed to. Until one day, a thought came to mind. What if I use the align panel with my anchor point selected? Well, it turns out that it works just as I expected. You just select your anchor points and align them however you want. Center, side, top, bottom, you name it. Is it the most helpful thing ever? Probably not, but it will still give you a hand when you need it. Have you ever lost 15 minutes selecting several copies of an object one by one throughout your artboards because you couldn't use the magic wand or just drag a box to select them all? Well, then this tip is for you. You just have to select one of the objects, then go to the Select menu and click on the Start Global Edit option. Even better, if you have the Properties panel, the Global Edit option will show at the very bottom. If you click on this arrow, it will bring up some options for you to refine the selection. Then, you can just go ahead and edit the object marked in red, and all the similar ones marked in blue will edit accordingly. Very similar to global editing, Illustrator also counts with the Select Similar function. It is located on the Select menu on the same option. You can refine the selection by choosing one of these parameters. Another option is to use this button on the control panel, which is the stop bar here. Just remember, it only pops up when you have an object selected. This function will select similar objects based on what attribute you selected, either on this drop-down menu here or through the select menu. It may look like it does the same thing as global edit, but remember, on Global Edit, you only select one object and Illustrator applies the changes you make to the other ones. But when you use Select Similar, it will actually select all of the objects. They are similar functions, but have different uses. And that's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, remember to like and subscribe to the channel. And if you have any thoughts regarding my content, leave your suggestions in the comment section. Thank you for watching, and I see you on the next video.